Hey fam, this is Miss V, and I'm in the historic town, Africa town, down in Mobile, Alabama. And we're here for the Spirit of Our Ancestors Festival. And we just got through seeing An Ocean in My Bones by Terrence Spivey, the award-winning Terrence Spivey. And it's an amazing production.
It was.
It really is. So now introduce yourself to the listening audience.
I am Felicia Moore. Mm-hmm. This is my first time doing the play. Mm-hmm. My sisters are production manager and stage manager. Uh-huh. And I got conned into doing
it. You got conned. How do you get conned into doing a play?
I was supposed to have a non-speaking role. Mm-hmm. I just came to rehearsal and I started talking with some of the other cast members. And next thing I know, Terrence said that I was playing City Anne.
Mm. So tell me about your experience. You've been, how long have you been rehearsing?
Probably since December.
So you've lived with this character for
yes.
a while. Tell me about this character and your experience.
She is sophisticated.
Is she?
Yeah, she is something else. But she knows her stuff.
Mm-hmm.
And she's from France.
Mm.
So I couldn't get the accent, so I guess I'm a little too southern.
No, you did fantastic.
Thank you. I appreciate that.
Uh-huh.
So, but you know, looking at her character and her mannerism, mm-hmm. how she dressed.
Mm-hmm.
Only thing was different is I have locks.
Okay. And so, she was a historian, right?
Yes, mm-hmm. yes.
And she documented.
She documented
some of the story of the Clotilda early
did.
On.
She did.
One of the first adapters.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Very smart, bright lady.
Yes.
Uh-huh. Like so now tell me, I had a favorite part in the play, and I have some favorite lines. You know, one of them is like, "I want to fly away. I want to fly back to Africa."
Yes.
Some of the lines, they just kind of hit me. Do you
yes.
have a favorite line or a favorite scene in the play?
Well, the whole play was awesome.
Mm-hmm.
Awesome.
It really was. Did you cry?
I did.
No.
I did several times.
That's mandatory. You cry.
The part I cried on is when the captives were on the boat and they mm-hmm. used the whip mm-hmm. and they had the sound of the whip.
Mm. That's DNA trauma right there.
Yes, yes.
So was
yes.
that one of your favorite parts?
It was not my favorite. No, that was not my favorite.
It just resonated.
Freedom was my favorite.
Yeah, yeah.
When they actually, mm-hmm. they're sitting there listening to each ancestor tell their story
yeah.
about how they got there and the things that they did
mm-hmm.
when they got here to change their strange environment into their home environment. That's what I like.
That's powerful.
That's what I like.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so you change in the situation that you're in and you could change it for the better.
Mm-hmm.
And that's what they did.
Well, how has this story affected you?
Yeah. It gave me knowledge about you live in Mobile, but you really don't hear what's going on. And I think so much that the schools that are here and by us being here in Mobile, they should teach those kids about what's going on. I don't know if Mobile County Training School does, but they have history here. And when you come to, in February, they want to know about Black history. It always goes back to slavery time.
Mm-hmm.
Why can't they tell them what happened after slavery time, what they did to help themselves, their community, their people, to advance themselves? So why does it always have to go back to that? We
mm-hmm.
already know about that.
Mm-hmm.
I want to hear about the after effect.
Mm-hmm. Well, somebody said in one of the earlier interviews, the Clotilda is the story of America.
Yes.
You know, and that resonated with me.
Yes.
Because it's people coming over with nothing, literally
nothing.
No clothes on their back.
Yes.
And having to make something. That's
yes.
the story of America.
That's it.
You know, and it's a powerful story.
It is, don't make me cry.
It truly is, and it's a story that needs to be told.
It does. It
so
really
going
does.
Forward, where do you see the Clotilda, this whole story going for not only the people of Plateau, Africa Town, but for the country, for the world? What do you see?
They need to put this on the screen.
On the big screen?
Yes.
The big screen. Really?
The story needs to be told.
Mm.
You know, Mobile is known for Mardi Gras,
mm-hmm.
but it's so much deeper than that.
Mm.
So much deeper than that. And I think they need to put it on. Each person that came here to see the play, they are in awe because a lot of people don't know the history.
We do not.
We don't know.
No.
So, put it out there. buy a ticket. Let's go forward. I don't think I want to do that part though.
Right.
No. Okay. I'm gonna be sitting in the audience.
All right. You gonna do it again next year?
I don't know.
Okay, that's called acting. Okay.
We'll talk about that later.
All right. Well, listen, before we go, tell our listening audience, our audience out there, where they can find you if they want to, you know, send you a message or find you on social media. Where can they contact you?
I am on Facebook as Felicia Austin Moore. It's just me. That's all I have.
Well, thank you for a wonderful interview. You
thank
did a
you.
Fantastic job.
Thank you.
And listen, I'm looking forward to seeing you next year. We'll be back.
Okay.
And I hope you're in the play.
Okay.
All right.
Thank you.
Thank you. All right. Peace out, family. All right.